How's it going, everyone? NDSean45 coming at ya. Let me start off this video by saying this. This year, 2016, is a big year for those of us who are either Irish or of Irish descent like myself all over the world. You see, this year marks the 100th anniversary of the Easter Uprising of 1916 in Ireland. Now, during Easter week of that year in 1916, several Irish rebels finally decided to take a stand against the British tyranny going on in that country. They said, enough is enough, we will no longer be ruled by the Crown of England. We're going to fight back and we're going to send them back to where they belong. And that's exactly what they did. That whole week, they fought and died for Irish independence. The last day of the revolt, they had no choice but to surrender. They had to originally abandon their headquarters and go into some buildings on a random street called Moore Street in Dublin, Ireland. Once they surrendered, they were all taken. The leaders were executed, and you know, even though they didn't accomplish everything that they wanted to, that set the stage for Michael Collins and his guerrilla warfare plan against the Brits. And you know, it got Irish people standing up and fighting back against tyranny. I mean, hey, myself being an American, you know, we all should know what that's about. You know, we fought against the British in the Revolutionary War to gain our independence after the tyranny they were imposing on us. So it was no different for Ireland. Now, even though those men and women of that 1916 revolt didn't accomplish quite what they wanted to, they got the ball rolling for the country of Ireland to fight back. They left their legacy, they left their history, and it should never, ever be forgotten by anybody who was either Irish or of Irish descent like myself for what they did. Now, the footage that you guys saw at the start of the video was from the movie Michael Collins, and it's only fitting for what I want to talk about here. You see, my good friend Jerry, you all know him as Shamrock Jerry here on YouTube, he had made me aware of some things that are going on over in Dublin right now, and I gotta tell you guys, what's happening over there right now is just... I'm disgusted by it. No, I take that back. I am beyond disgusted. I am just sick, completely sick to my stomach over what is going on. You guys see from the title of this video that says it says Protect Moore Street. Well, what is Moore Street, you ask? Well, during that Easter week in 1916, that's the street where the Irish rebels went to when they were forced to leave their original headquarters. They hid in some houses on that street, and they kept the fighting going from there. Their last days were spent there in a living hell. I mean, I can only imagine, you know. But it was so severe that there were actually priests in those houses giving them last rites as they went into their final days of battle and the final days of their lives. Well, Jerry has told me that over in Ireland right now, there are some greedy bankers and some corrupt Irish politicians that are backing the idea of demolishing Moore Street, where those historical buildings are, buildings that date back to the 1760s, so they're about 250 years old. That, you know, these greedy bankers and these corrupt Irish politicians want to demolish the whole street and put a shopping mall there. That is just sickening. Just what a despicable and diabolical act to even consider in the first place. Now, some of you are probably wondering, well, Sean, you're an American. You live in America. Why are you even concerning yourself with this? Well, I will say this. Yeah, that's a fact. Since I am an American first, and I have to deal with things that are happening in my own backyard here in America first, of course. Absolutely. But at the same time, though, I'm not going to just abandon my heritage either. You know, when I hear something like this that is going on in my family and being Ireland, yeah, that pisses me off, and I'm going to say something about it. And honestly, if I didn't have my buddy Jerry in my life, I probably wouldn't even know about this, because to tell you guys the truth, I haven't seen Moore Street trending on Facebook. I haven't seen it trending on Twitter. I haven't seen anything about it in the news over here. I mean, granted, I don't watch any of the mainstream news networks, but I doubt they're covering it. So if Jerry wasn't my friend, I probably wouldn't even know about it. But, you know, it really is sickening, because even though I am an American first, that doesn't mean that I'm just going to ignore my heritage, because we never should just forget about our heritage. We should always try to continue learning about it as time goes along. And Ireland will always be a part of my heritage. But I just find it very disgraceful and sickening that these politicians and these greedy-ass bankers want to tear those buildings down, basically crap on the legacy and the history of the people who fought and died for you guys to be the jerk-offs that you are and the morons that you are, referring to the Irish politicians who actually are backing this. Now, granted, I don't know a lot about Irish politics, but from what I've been informed on is, like, the, you know, I'm not very familiar with their political parties either. But from what I hear, their political parties, like the Fianna Gael, I believe. Apparently, they've been corrupt for the last 40 or 50 years. And I just got to say, you know, to groups like that who are supporting this move of bulldozing these buildings over, you know, where has your backbone gone? You are selling out your own country and your own history to line your greedy ass pockets. I mean, and honestly, you know, on the other side of the coin, there could be some Irishmen who see this video, some native Irish citizens, and are probably saying, "Well, gee, Yank, what do you know? You don't live here. Why are you concerning yourself with our personal matters over here?" Well, let me tell you what I do know. I know that I traveled to Ireland for the first time back in 2012 during the week of the Emerald Isle Classic when Notre Dame and Navy were playing over there. I know that Jerry drove us by Moore Street, and I saw those buildings where the rebels hid. I also know that I visited Kilmainham Jail, where those rebels were held and their leaders were executed. I saw the field where their leaders were executed by firing squad. I saw the hooks outside where some of them were hanged. And here's the proof of that. So there you go, people. I saw it up close and personal with my own eyes where these men were imprisoned and executed. And also, something else I have to point out, something very stupid that I read in the Irish Daily News today, an article that was printed a couple days ago, actually. Someone said that these buildings on Moore Street have no historical value to them whatsoever, or significance. What a load of bullcrap. Oh no, just the people who hid in those buildings for the final days of their lives, fighting for your country's independence, and yeah, it has no significant meaning, right? I mean, how stupid can you be, whoever said that? And I think that it was the same person who also said, "Oh, well, those buildings were already in ruins at the time of 1916. Well, they go back to the 1760s, moron. Of course, there's going to be some wear and tear on them. I mean, how stupid can a person be? I mean, really. But look, all I can say is this, people. What's going on in Dublin right now with Moore Street and these greedy bastard politicians and bankers who are leading it, it's basically the equivalent is if the politicians and, you know, corporations here wanted to say, bulldoze the Alamo and put a Burger King in its place, or remove all the headstones and the monuments from Gettysburg, you know, the battlefield, to put a shopping mall over it in its place. It's disgraceful. It is a despicable act, and it pisses on the legacy of all the men and women who fought and died for, you know, to leave their mark in fighting for independence. And all I can say is to the politicians and the bankers who are leading this agenda, I guess you'd call it, to demolish this terrorist altogether, shame on you, and may God have mercy on your soul. I mean, if they do this, if they demolish this neighborhood, then Ireland has officially lost its heart. It really has. It's despicable that this was even considered in the first place. Men and women who died for your freedom, and you want to piss on their legacy like that. I'm going to finish this video off by reading this. The Provisional Government of the Irish Republic to the People of Ireland. Irish men and Irish women, in the name of God and of the dead generations from which she receives her old tradition of nationhood, Ireland through us summons her children to her flag and strikes for her freedom. Having organized and trained her manhood through her secret revolutionary organization, the Irish Republican Brotherhood, and through her open military organizations, the Irish Volunteers, and the Irish Citizen Army, having patiently perfected her discipline, having resolutely waited for the right moment to reveal itself, she now seizes that moment, and supported by her exiled children in America and by gallant allies in Europe, but relying in the first on her own strength, she strikes in full confidence of victory. We declare the right of the people of Ireland to the ownership of Ireland and to the unfettered control of Irish destinies to be sovereign and indefeasible. The long usurpation of that right by a foreign people and government has not extinguished the right, nor can it ever be extinguished except by the destruction of the Irish people. In every generation, the Irish people have asserted their right to national freedom and sovereignty. 6 times during the past 300 years, they have asserted it in arms, standing on the fundamental right and again asserting it in arms in the face of the world. We hereby proclaim the Irish Republic as a sovereign, independent state. And we pledge our lives and the lives of our comrades in arms to the cause of its freedom, of its welfare, and of its its exaltation among the nations. The Irish Republic is entitled to and hereby claims the allegiance of every Irishman and Irishwoman. The Republic guarantees religious and civil liberty, equal rights, and equal opportunities of all its citizens, and declares its resolve to pursue the happiness and prosperity of the whole nation and of all its parts, cherishing all the children of the nation equally and oblivious of the differences carefully fostered by an alien government, which have divided a minority in the past. Until our arms have brought the opportune moment for the establishment of a permanent national government, representative of the whole world, of the whole people of Ireland, and elected by the suffrages of all her men and women, the Provisional Government, hereby constituted, will administer the civil and military affairs of the Republic and trust for the people. We place the cause of the Irish Republic under the protection of the Most High God, whose blessing we invoke upon our arms, and we pray that no one who serves that cause will dishonor it by cowardice, inhumanity, or rapine. Excuse me. In this supreme hour, the Irish nation must, by its valor and discipline, and by the readiness of its children to sacrifice themselves for the common good, prove itself worthy of the august destiny to which it is called. Signed by Thomas J. Clark, Sean McDimarta, Thomas McDonough, P.H. Pierce, Iman Sienet, if I pronounced that wrong, I apologize, James Connolly, and Joseph Plunkett. God bless, and Aaron Gobrah.